The following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 2nd Canto, 1st Chapter, text number 5, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on November 8, 1973, in New Delhi, India.
Translation. O descendant of King Bharata, one who desires to be free from all miseries, must hear, glorify, and also remember the personality of Godhead, who is the Super Soul, the Controller, and the Savior from all miseries.
Tasmad Bharata Sarvatma Bhagavan Ishara Hari Srutabhya Kitabhasya Smartabhasya Kichadamakutu Vayam Ishtatam Abhayam. So, Sukadeva Goswami is giving instruction to Maharaj Parikshit what is to be done at the point of death. We have already discussed this point, that we must know the responsibility of our next life, just like a child is given education for the next life, to become youthful, to get into higher education, admission, then a youth is given higher education for better life in future. That is natural. Everyone is expecting future prospects. Similarly, every one of us, we are changing our body exactly the same way as the child is changing his body to boyhood, the boy is changing his body to youthhood, the youth is changing his body to old body. Similarly, after old age, there is next stage is death. So after death, what is the proposal? That they do not know. Practically, we are experiencing that although I am changing body, I was a child, I was a boy, I was a young man, now I'm old man. So there was past and future in every stage. Similarly, in this stage, as I am remembering my past life, I can remember, you can remember. I was a child, I was a boy, I was a young man, I was doing like this. Everything I remember. Even if I forget, I had my past life, and again, I expect my future life. Past, present and future. Why the future should be zero? We have experienced so long both past, present and future, why in this old age I shall be futureless, but there is no life after death. That is the foolishness. That we are not preparing. Those who are not preparing, they are engaged in various topics. Sutubhyani charajendra ninangshanti sahasrasa. Apashyatamatmatattvam grihesu grihamedina. They have created a life of material enjoyment, and therefore they have many things to hear, srutubhyadini, so many newspapers, magazines, books, fictions, simply for wasting time. There is no discussion in those literatures about future life. None of these literature. Take any literature of the modern world. There is no discussion about the future life. But the future life is there. You cannot deny it. The future life is there. But there is no discussion. Therefore, these rascals have been described as apashyatam atmatattvam. These rascals, they do not see what is the future? They do not believe in future. Big professors, big politicians, they do not believe in that there is life after death. Now why there is no life after death? We are experiencing that life after life. It's like this child's activities at the present moment will not be the same when she will get another body as a young woman. That will be a different activity. So according to our change of body, we have got different engagements. A child talks all foolish things, nobody cares for it. But the same child, when he gets another body, if he talks foolish, then he will be called, "Oh, you are so fool, you are talking like this," because the body has changed. So body is changing, that's a fact. But apasyatam atmatattam, one who does not know that the spirit soul is eternal and changing body, they are blind, apasyatam atmatattam. They are simply engrossed in this bodily concept of life. Griheshu grihamedhina, compact, encased in this body, encased in society, encased in nationalism, encased in religion, encased in ideas, philosophy. But there is no question of discussing about the soul. So for them, these foolish persons, those who are not seeing the actual position, constitutional position of the soul, and the future of the soul, for them there are many topics, unlimited. Sotobhani, Sotobuddha, Sahasrani, hundreds and thousands, Nirangsanti Sahasrani, Apasyatam Atmatattam, this sloka you have described. What is their subject matter of discussion? The subject matter is the Nidrahyate Naktam, Bhavayana cha bhavaya. At night they sleep or indulge in sex life, and in daytime divacharte hayarajan kutumma bharanena va. And the daytime is wasted. Where is money? And if he gets money, how to purchase this thing for that boy, how to purchase for my wife, for my brother? Kutumma bharanena va. Purchases, where is milk, where is rice, where is... In this way, we are wasting time. Although this human form of life is meant for Brahma realization, athāta Brahma jīgyāsa, they have forgotten that. Therefore, Sukadeva Goswami is reminding that at the end of life, at the time of death, one must do it. But not only at the end of life, one must practice from the beginning of life. Just like Prahlad Maharaj said, "Ko maro acharit pragya dharman bhagavatani." This prescription given by Sukadeva Goswami, "Tasmad bharata sarvatma bhagavan ishvaro hari srutabva kirtitabvascha smartabvascha ichchata abhayam." This is Bhagavad Dharma. Everything in relationship with the Supreme Personality of God. Dharma means Bhagavad Dharma. Otherwise that is not dharma. Dharmantu sakshat bhagavat panitam. Dharma means to understand God, our relationship with God, and how to work in that relationship. That is dharma. Sambandha prayajan, sambandha avidya prayajan. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu prescribes this. The whole Vedic civilization is based on this. That you must know what is your relationship with God. It doesn't matter whether you are Hindu, Muslim, Christian, or Buddhist. A civilized man must have some religious process. That is all over the world. Now we are giving up. We are giving up. Therefore, dharmena hina pasivi sama. Dharmena hina pasivi. When we give up the religious principle means to abide by the law of God. That is religion. But we do not know what is God and what is His order. We forget it. So, at the present moment, dharmi na hina pasubhi samana, it is a civilization of cats and dogs, not human beings, because they are given a dharma. But the Shastra says that this human life is meant for understanding God, nothing else. Other things are already arranged. You are harassed by the problems of eating, sleeping, mating. But there is no such question. Eating arrangement is there. Even the birds and bees, they are confident. They have no office going. They are not lawyers, engineers, politicians to earn their bread. But the bread is ready for them. Even for the bees, birds. So they are confident. So this is not problem. Real problem is to understand God. And what will the benefit by understanding God? Then the problem of your birth, death, old age and disease will be solved. That is the real problem. We are undergoing repetition of birth, death, old age and disease. These problems can be solved simply by understanding what is God. This is the solution. That is mentioned in the Bhagavad Gita. Janma karma me dibbam ju janati tattva. Prakta deham punar janma naiti. Prakta deham punar janma naiti. This is the solution. Janma karma me dibbam. Krishna says, God says, that if you try to understand me, what is my position, why I descend, what is my activity, what is... That is described here. Srotavya. You have to understand. How you will understand? By hearing. God has given you the ear. If you simply hear, there is no question of education. It is not that one who is not educated, he will not understand what is God. He will understand. Because the ear is there. Sarvanam Kirtanam Vishnu. Vishnu of Lord, this is Supreme Personality of Godhead. You hear. Therefore we are opening so many branches, just to give people the chance of hearing. And as soon as you perfectly hear, the next position will be to glorify. Just like these European American boys. First of all they heard, now they are preaching. Savanam Kirtanam. Because they have perfectly heard, therefore they are very enthusiastic, they are going all over the world, they are preaching. The Srotavya Kirtanam Vashtya. If one has actually heard, know about God, then the next stage will be, he will be very much enthusiastic to speak to others. That is preaching. Srotavya Kirtanam Vashtya Smartavya. Smartabha means remembering. Unless you remember what is God, what is His form, what is His quality, what is His pastime, what is our activities, what are His entourage, everything about God. If you hear, just like if you hear Bhagavad Gita, you understand everything. What is God? And that is our only duty. I have seen in this Delhi, near Juma Masjid, the small Mohammedan boys, they are reading Quran. That's very good. From childhood, they should learn about God. And that is the recommendation in Bhagavad. Prahlad Maharaj said, that Kumaro Acharet Praga Dharmana Bhagavatam. Kumar, from the beginning of life. Children should be engaged. Therefore we have opened the Gurukul, Dallas. The small children, 4 years, 5 years old, they are hearing about Krishna, about God. They are chanting about Krishna. They are rising early in the morning, attending Mangalaratri. Anyone goes there. Even the education superintendent came to visit our temple. He was astonished how these children are happy, how children, they are being educated. This is to be introduced. Kaumaram acharat prajna dharman bhagavat durlabham manusam janma. This human form of life is durlabham. Durlabham, very rare to achieve. It is not so easily obtained. We have to pass through evolutionary process. 8,400,000 species of life, aquatics, jalajana valakhani, thavara lokhavimshati. We have to pass through aquatics, animals in the water, then trees, plants, then insects, birds, beasts. After all, we get this human form of life, especially civilized form of life, with some idea of religion. If we do not utilize it, religion means to understand God, that is religion. In religion, a godless religion, where there is no conception of God, that is not religion. That is called cheating religion, in the name of religion, but there is no conception of God. That is not religion. Well, here it is said that Srotabha, Bhagavan, if you do not know who is Bhagavan, if you do not know who is Hari, if you do not know who is Ishvara, then what you will hear about? That is the problem. Those who are after God, they make God nirakha. There is no akha. There is no ka. God is the origin of all forms, but the poor God has no form. This is the conclusion. He is the origin of all forms. Yatoba imani bhutani jayanti, from whom everything is coming out. Janmadrasya jata, everything is, we have also come from God. We are also claimed as sons of God. Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, sarva jonishu kaunteya sammamanti murtahya. There are 8,400,000 species of life, and they have got forms. They are sons of God. So where is our experience that a son who has got a form, his father is impersonal, no form? Where you have got this experience? If the son has got form and the father is formless, how it can be? What is the reason? What is the argument? But they are concluding like that. I am the son of my father, so my father has got a form, I have got a form. His father has got form, his father has got form. Even if we do not see the 10th generation up to, whether it was formed or formless, but it is supposed that he must have a form. So similarly, if you ultimately go to the Supreme Father, then how it is formless? No. Formless is not the actual realization of God. That is the beginning. That may be beginning. To realize the energy of God, that is formless. Just like the sun sign is formless, but the sun globe is not formless. Or the person, the predominating deity within the sun globe, he is not formless. The sun sign is formless. So this formless realization, just like the sun is also light, sun is also heat, this sun sign is also light, sun sign is also heat, but this heat and light, energy of the sun, they are not actually the sun. It is only the energy. This is described in the Vishnu Purana, that eko deshe sthito shagne josna vistarina jatha parasya brahmana shakti sarvedam akilam jagat. Just like a fire is there in one place, in a particular localized place, but it expands in heat and light. Similarly, the Supreme Personality of Godhead is there. His person, that is described in the Brahma Sanghita, goloka eva nivasati akilatma bhuta, that is God. Although he is everywhere present by his energy, it does not mean that he is lost. He has lost his personality. No. Purnasya purnamadaya purnameva vasishyate. He's so perfect and complete. Just like you take the example of the sun, for millions and millions of years, unlimited temperature, light and heat is coming out. But still it is the same. Purnasya Purnamadaya, Purnameva Vasishtyate. Similarly, God is so perfect, so complete, that unlimited number of suns and energies, we are also energy. We, sons of God, we are also energy. That is described in the Bhagavad Gita. Aparayam itastu vidhime prakritim para jiva bhuta mahabaho jayedam dharyate jagat. Prakritim para. This material world is apara prakriti. And prakriti, nature, or energy, this is inferior energy, the matter, dull matter. But aparayam, bhumirapa analavayu, earth, water, air, fire, they are inferior energy of the Lord. But there is another superior nature, that is the sky. Aparayam, these energies, bhumirapa analavayu, earth, water, air, they are inferior. There is another superior. What is that? Jiva-bhuta, these living entities. Mahabhava. Jayedam dharjate jagat. Who are controlling? Now, this Delhi city is important. Why important? Because the jiva-bhuta, the living entities, they are handling this material, cement and stone and wood and so many other material things. And they are constructing buildings. And therefore, the importance of this Delhi city is there. If all the people, all the living entities leave this Delhi city, it is not even one farthing worth. Jiva-bhuta mahavayo jayidam dharjati jagat. In Calcutta, in 1942, when there was bombing, and all Calcutta was vacated, a house at that time, which was rented at 200 rupees, they were asking, give me 25 rupees. Because the living entity is vacated. Similarly, the importance of this material world is there because we living entities are here. And we have come here. Krishna Bhuliyaji Bhagavancha, all the living entities, they have come into this material world to enjoy material enjoyment. Therefore, this material world has wealth. Otherwise, if all the living entities go back again, back to home, back to garden, this matter has no value. So we are also prakriti. We are also energy of God. And because we are trying to utilize the resources of matter, therefore material things have got value. Otherwise there's no value. Jiva. But our business is, that is stated here, that because we are now entangled with this matter, the matter is not our business. Our only business is how to get out of the matter. That is our real business. If you want that business, then the prescription is here. What is that? Srutabha kirtitabhascha. Unless you hear, how you can understand your position? When you understand God, Krishna, and you understand that you are part and parcel of God or Krishna, then we can understand your position. So, we are part and parcel of God. Krishna is the Supreme Person, Sarayasajya Purna, full of all opulences. Just like a mad son loitering in the street, when he understands with good brain that my father is so rich, so powerful, and why I am loitering in the street like a madman, and I have no food, no shelter, I am going from this door to door and begging. Then he comes to his consciousness. That is called Brahma-bhuta state. I am not this matter. I am spirit soul, part and parcel of God. That is consciousness. This consciousness we are trying to arouse. This is the best welfare service to the people, to awaken his lost consciousness. He is foolishly thinking that I am of the material product. And I have to adjust my things in this material world. This is the foolishness. Actual intelligence, that's Brahma-bhuta, aham brahmasmi. am Brahmasmi, I am part and parcel of God. God is Supreme Brahma. I am being part and parcel. Just like part and parcel of the gold mine. It may be small earning. It is also gold. Similarly, the small particle of seawater is also the same quality, salty. Similarly, we being part and parcel of God, we have got the same qualities. Qualitatively, we are one. Why you are hankering after loving? Because there is love in Krishna. We are worshipping here Radha Krishna. Originally, there is love. Therefore, we being part and parcel of God, we are also trying to love. A man is trying to love another, woman is trying to love another man. This is natural, this is not artificial, but it is parvartic in the material cause. That is the defect. When we are free from this material covenant, then we are qualitatively anandamaya bhyasa, as jolly as Krishna is dancing always. Krishna is never fine. You have seen the picture of Krishna. He's fighting with the Kaliya serpent. He's dancing. He's not afraid of the serpent. He's dancing. As he's dancing with the gopis in Rasila, similarly he's dancing with the snake. Because he's anandamaya vyasa, he is anandamaya. Always jolly. You'll see Krishna just like in Kurukshetra, the fighting is going on. Krishna is jolly. Arjuna is morose. Because he is living entity. But he is not morose. He is jolly. That is the nature of God. Anandamaya Vyasa. This is the sutra in the Brahma Sutra. That God is anandamaya. Always jolly. Always cheerful. So you can become also cheerful when you go back to home, back to God. That is our problem. Therefore, how we can go there? The first thing is we must hear Shrutabhyo. Just try to hear what is God, what is His kingdom, how He acts, how He is cheerful. These things have to be heard. Savanam. Then as soon as you are convinced, God is so nice, then you will be eager to demonstrate or to broadcast this news to the whole world. This is Kirtanam. This is Kirtanam. Savanam Kirtanam Vishnu Smaranam Padasevanam. Archanang Bandanang Dasam Sakhamapunidam. This is life. Otherwise, they're talking nonsense, taking a newspaper in the morning, and this party has done like this, this man has declared war, that man has defeated this. These are simply waste of time. If we waste our time, then you are not preparing for the next life. The actually human form or five is meant for preparing for the next one. Sadatadhavabhavita. Janjangabhapismananvabhavam tajatanti kalambaram. If we actually serious about our life, to get free from all the problems of life, then this is the only medicine. What is that? Tasmad bharata sarvatma. Bhagavan isharo hari. Srutabhya. One has to hear. It is not very difficult. But people have become so rascal, so foolish, they will not hear. We are requesting, we have not manufactured anything. It is all authorized. Authorized books, Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavat, Vedic literature. We are simply inviting them. Now, where is their, sectarianism? If we say to you, either you are Hindu or Muslim or Christian, if we say that please hear about God, where is sectarianism? Your life is meant for, if we preach, that your life is meant for hearing. Now we are presenting Krishna as the Supreme Personality of God. If you don't accept Supreme Personality of God, Krishna, then what is your Supreme Personality of God? You present. Then you compare who is actually Supreme Personality of God. What is the meaning of Supreme Personality of God? Why are you taking? Why you are taking sectarian? Krishna claims sarvajuni sukanta. All forms of life, not only human forms of life, even animal forms of life, vegetable forms of life, aquatic, they are all. Actually, that is the fact. We are not this form, we are not this body, but according to our mentality, by nature's law, we are getting a particular type of body. Actually, I am spirit soul. Dehinasmin yatha dehi kaumara yuvanangara. Just like I am developing my ideas, youthful ideas, I am getting the youthful body. I am developing childish ideas, I am getting childhood body. As you develop, Krishna or God has given you full freedom. You have come to this material world to enjoy. Now you make your plan according of your enjoyment. God will give you a particular type of body and you enjoy. Just like the hog, he's enjoying. What is enjoying? He's enjoying stool. It is very good for him enjoyment, but it is not for enjoyment for you. You're like, what a nasty animal it is, it is eating stool. But he is enjoying. So this is the business of God, thankless task. Everyone wants to enjoy life in a different way. And he has to find out a particular type of body. In the human form of body, you cannot eat stool. Your mouth, your hands, your legs are differently made. But for eating stool, you must have a particular type of body, mouth, taste, tongue, everything different. Then you will enjoy stool. A tiger, his body is different because he wants to enjoy fresh blood from another animal. So he has got a different type. Therefore, Narottam Das Thakur says, Nanajani Brahman Kare Kadarja Bhokkhanapar. Kadarja Bhokkhanapar. We get different types of body and we eat different types of all nasty things. Nasty things. Because we have got a particular type of body. But actual human body is that Krishna conscious body. This Krishna says, Patram puspam phalam tuyam jumi bhaktya prajacchati taya bhaktya vritam asnami. Krishna says, give me patram puspam, vegetable, flowers, grains, meal, so you can prepare hundreds and thousands of preparation from this article and you take the remnants of pushta Krishna. That is human life. Not to eat kodarja. Kodarja are nasty things. That is not human life. So, if you continue to eat all the kadarjas, then you get ultimately the body of a hog. No discrimination, even for stool. That is the laws of nature. Prakite kriyamanani gunai karmani sarvasmi. Ahankara vimuratma kartaham iti manmati. Prakriti, nature will give you chance. All right, you want this mind. You are creating. Mind is the creating force. So,